Good morning, my name's Dave and welcome back to the Wookiee Fly Fishing Channel.
Well, if you can see the terrapin, can you see it? We have a terrapin.
We're here today at Checker Tree and I think we're going to concentrate on buzzers today.
Okay, so there's my cast on an intermediate line, dowel on the top dropper and then a yellow, looks like a crisp packet buzzer, and then another orange buzzer and then a tinsel booby on the point. I'm going to fish it on a slow intermediate, really long leader, but just let it sink naturally and see how we go.
So I'm fishing a 4-fly cast, which is really unusual to be fair for small still water fishing, but the water clarity here is pretty poor. I'm fishing tiny sort of size 14s, size 12s, so I'm fishing them 2 foot apart and I've tied them in line. And the reason I've tied them in line is, you know, no one likes fishing droppers and getting tangled up. And if you're fishing 4-flies, obviously you've got more chance of tangles. So I've tied them in line. I'm fishing them almost static anyway. Not too worried about presentation, just because of the water clarity. So it's not the traditional way, and it's not my preferred method. I just thought today I'll try and show you something a little bit different. Lots of movement today. The terrapin that lives in these waters, and I've seen him 3 or 4 times this morning already. And there's lots and lots of topping, the gentle breeze. This is a non-windward bank, but the wind's blowing over towards that direction. So I will literally be doing no more than 5 or 10 casts in each swim, then just moving around. The lake's all mine. So just gonna have a cheeky 4-hour session midweek, and it's only 15 minutes from home, and try and show you something a little bit new. We're off fishing again on Sunday, back to Tenterden. Got an afternoon session there. We normally do morning sessions, but we booked an afternoon session because we're hoping for a bit of a hatch if it stays this warm. So I might be doing a little bit of shipman's fishing or something, or some top hat buzzer fishing in my favourite corner, Dam End. So that should be on the next video. So we're trying to give you as much content as we can and vary it as much as we can. So I hope you like what we're doing so far. Anything you'd like us to show you, please leave in the comments and we'll try and accommodate. We do plan to travel further afield to some of the bigger fish waters. Thing is with these other waters, when we go as often as we do, catch and release is a great option for us really. I mean, who's got the freezer space? Let's be fair, catching 4 fish every week with trout coming at your ears. But we are going to go further afield. We are going to, you know, as the channel grows, we'll be out to Deva and places like that, try and get some big fish on the channel for you. Or maybe Rockbourne and places like that. We're also planning on going to Bure Water and showing you a bit of boat fishing at some stage. nice to finally have some sun, because the last three trips we've got absolutely soaked. Brick farm was a washout in the last video. Still caught fish, but not a pleasant day. Wonderful venue, Brick Farm, beautiful place. I would fish there every day if it was closer. And catch and release.
And with this Cortland 444 line, it's so slow sinking. You know, you can vary your count. You fish all the water columns with this line. Like you said on most of my videos, it is my go-to line, really. You're in touch with the flies at all times because, you know, you're in tension with the flies. It's amazing how your fishing changes when you start making these videos. Because I think as anglers we're a bit lazy. We have like 10 flies that we love. Oh, I'm only going to fish those 10 flies. Because I'm good at fishing those 10 flies. But you start making videos and you start thinking about what else can I show. And you end up fishing outside your comfort zone, fishing different methods that you probably, you know. Oh, there's that big brown. Just seen him again. He's dirty. Dirty, great big thing. Come on. Oh, what a fish. Paddle on him. God, it's like Red October going past. Oh. Seriously, that would make my day. If I could get into him. Oh! There's another one out there I can see. I'm right on it. Oh! Even in dirty water like this, it just goes to show, if you've got a good pair of glasses, you can still see the fish. Oh, there he is. That's that one that I put the flies on top of. It's not big enough to be a brown, though. No, it's not. Thank you. Fish number two. Is it funny where you think the fish are, exactly where you had takes on previous trips? Always cast your favourite little spots, don't they? You know, oh, the fish are there, that's where they are, they're right there. Well, they're there, but they're not there. Oh, you fighter. Explode onto that. Just a head shake on this one. Alright, so subtle change. My head got the better of me. Gonna put a bigger booby on. Because we all like bigger boobies. Just seen a goldfish rise. Oh, I didn't think that was a fish, I thought I'd snagged. I actually thought that was a snag. A bit carefully because I'm quite a long leader. Oh, you little fighter.
Well, so we had three fish in 2 hours on the inline washing line, or whatever you want to call it. It's not probably the best presentation, but in dirty water like this, you know, you can fish flies 2-3 foot apart, and just by tying them in line, you've got no issues with tangles. So we gave it a go. We had three nice fish in 2 hours. Saw that dirty red brown, obviously the tail on it. Oh my God. But got rid of the take of the thing. So I'm now going to switch over to the floating line, because it's that lunchtime sort of period where it just goes a bit flat. So I'm going to put a black daddy on the short leader, probably about 10, 12 foot. Just fish single fly on the floating line and see if I can't entice another take before I go home at 2 o'clock. So, hope you enjoyed the video. Catch you next time.